You're listening to IBNX. IBNXradio.com.
You know what it is? Coming through your speaker, introducing real hip hop. So nice to meet you. Sounds of the underground, local wolf from out of town. Real rap, who's up next? Who needs to sit down? Happy Hour Radio, what have you so addicted? Pull one, blow one, zone out, get lifted. If you playing ball in a bossin', it's for the whole team. 7 to 9, a dose of dopeness for you, dope fiends.
Yeah.
What up?
Hey, hey, hey.
Hey, little, little,
Lizzie. With our special, special New Year's episode.
Hey.
Oh, man. Oh man, it feels good to be here and alive and to the end at the end of 2016, like for real.
Yeah.
Cause wow,
it's been a rough year.
It's been a long year.
Well, you know what? You're almost on the end, baby. The last stretch.
Oh man, the last stretch for real, for real. But look, I want to say shout out to everybody who has struggled through 2016 and made it to the end. Shout out to all the people who's looking forward to 2017.
Shout out to all the people who made it, you know?
Absolutely.
And shout out to the people who didn't, you know?
Or
still got, you know,
I guess that's
2016, claimed some people. You know, yesterday, Carrie Fisher died, Princess Leia. You know, I don't know if all you guys are geeks like me, but
that's my biggest man. I was the biggest fan.
Shush. Somebody respected that.
I mean, but no, yeah, that rip.
But yeah, you know.
Paula, what's going on in your day, bro?
My day, you know, it's been pretty good, you know. Nothing really bad happened. But as for my week, my job got threatened.
Oh.
So, you know, maybe this is possibly going to be my full-time job, which isn't a bad thing. But, you know, hey.
2017
is almost,
you know,
at the end, so.
Time to kick old things to the side.
I ain't worried about that job either. I don't care if you listen.
F your job.
Shoot. And what about you, Kayshawn?
You know, my day was okay. I found out my cheagle, my chihuahua mixed with a beagle, is actually mixed with a lab. So it's a weagle. Now I'm playing. I don't know what that beagle mixed with a lab. I don't know.
It's illegal.
But yeah, so you know, it's not going to be a small dog. It's going to be a big dog.
Basically, we got a guard dog. You come in at our door. You
want a guard dog named Chi Chi. Chi Chi, sick him. Yeah, it sounds threatening.
That's not threatening at all. Yeah, I've been doing good. You know, doing my thing, DJing, editing videos. And I want to say shout out to my boy Richie, who is heading back to New York to restock up on Tim's and New York's snapbacks. And shout out to Richie also, all the way up here playing nothing but Jamaican music. Shout out to my Jamaicans and shout out to my beautiful Jamaican woman who'll be taking frog splashes to the back and doing dance hall.
Okay.
And a serious shout out to a friend of ours. You guys may have known him, 10K. He's in the hospital right now. Prayers up for him.
Yes,
we're going to do a special 10K a special 10K segment.
Yeah.
You know,
sometime during the show.
Yes.
But we have a very
special, as a preview of it.
But like I said, we have a very, 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 very special show for y'all today, because we're gonna have nothing but ciphers. Ciphers coming.
Oh yeah, if you've been following us on Instagram, then you know that we got everybody, well, not everybody, but people who wanted to come back from anybody who sat in the seat, they were allowed to, you know, come back and spit some bars off the top. So I know you guys are going to be excited for that. It's a little something new, you know. A little something new going into the new year. Blah, blah, blah.
What?
Silence your phone, Kayshawn. Be professional.
Yeah, professional.
All of your favorite interviewers, you are interviewees, y'all interviews that y'all been listening to.
Yeah.
Is that how it go? Well, yeah, all of them, not all of them, but a good amount is coming back to y'all to spit something for y'all. So, you know, all you hip hop fans and all you fans of these artists. So stay tuned and y'all going to hear it.
Some bars, bars on bars on bars.
So, yeah, what we got coming on? Tell us our DNA. What's your ear?
Up next.
What's your ear saying, man? What's your ear picking up?
But I be hearing is swing by Ray Sherman.
Swing.
I thought you said we was gonna play reggae. Yeah.
I lied.
You liar.
Welcome to the Grapevine with
Kayshawn.
Good people who have traveled from villages near and far, lend me your ears.
Ooh. Hey guys, and welcome to the Grapevine with Kayshawn. All right, so we're going to get right into it. All right, so, you know, this holiday season, you had a lot of people who went out of town to visit their family and friends. Some people drove. Some people flew airplanes or rode on airplanes. And some people got kicked off of airplanes. Okay? Mm. So one person in particular who got kicked off of this plane, his name is Adam Saleh. Or Adam Saleh.
Sound like he should be kicked off of a plane.
Oh, wow.
Oh, shots.
Both of you is wrong. Continue.
But anyway, so this is pretty much what happened. So apparently he was on the plane with his friend and, you know, he was talking to his mom on the phone. Mm-hmm. They're speaking in Arabic. He was talking to his friend and his mom in Arabic. And I guess, you know, the people who were on the flight as well heard that. They felt uncomfortable and they let the flight attendants know. So this resulted into a huge thing where they ended up getting kicked off of the plane because a lot of people felt uncomfortable because he was speaking in Arabic. Mm-hmm. So the biggest thing about this, if you saw the video, I saw the video and I actually felt really bad. Like, I was offended. I was like, how can people just be so freaking racist? You know, like on the video, you have people waving to the camera like, bye, like you should be kicked off the plane. I was pissed off. I was like, that's so sad. But when you actually look into it, this guy, he's a big YouTube star, and his whole thing with his YouTube channel, he does pranks. That's his whole YouTube channel. He does pranks. He's a prankster. So, like, that leaves you to question, is this whole thing, was it real or was it fake? You know, so after looking into it, it actually turned out to be a hoax. He's still claiming that it's true, everything's true, but apparently there was a person who was like two seats behind them and they weren't speaking to the mom. Instead, this YouTuber was speaking to his friend in Arabic, was like, I need you to shout out something in Arabic, just playing around with people. So he shouted it out and of course people got uncomfortable, they got kicked off, and he made a huge deal of it. He was on like the news. Right after that, he made a YouTube channel or YouTube video about it. You know, and I just don't think that's right, because that messes up not only him but just people in his community. That affects people, you know.
Yeah, he won.
I mean, I'm pretty sure like they were already affected anyway. Like, yeah, like the situation was, if you speak Arabic, this is going to make people feel uncomfortable, because we know what happens when people speak Arabic on planes.
What happens?
A bomb follows.
Oh my God.
And like, you know what?
I was actually shut down.
Right? But I was looking at his YouTube page and like, okay, these are some of the videos. So it is counting down in Arabic on a plane, speaking Arabic on a plane, Arabs on the plane, never wear this on the plane in America.
Sounds like this guy asked me if he's sent to Guantanamo Bay.
Oh my God.
So, I mean, look, it's his own fault. After that, I was like, I don't feel bad for him. He posted the whole thing on Twitter. After that, he went on Periscope. Now, after that, he made a YouTube video about it. So, I don't feel bad. I feel bad for his people. You shouldn't play around like that. That's not cool.
I think you should. Let me see.
Really?
I think that both of them, because he didn't, they couldn't even understand him. You know, it's not like he was like, death to America, death to America.
And but
he was
just like, shouting out in Arabic, though.
So?
Like, the passenger that was on the flight was like, he thought that he was probably shouting to a friend, but he did it about four times, just shouting, just being unnecessarily just disruptive.
I don't know how many times I was on the plane and I saw a disgruntled white man yelling over some bullshit, like sports. We wasn't like, hey, buddy, get off the plane. No, we was like, hey, he's yelling, we'll get over it. But because it's in another language, it's automatically death to America.
Yeah. Okay,
look,
well,
people fear what they don't understand. And when you're on a plane and you know anything that can cause any kind of commotion, people like, Like, try surviving 20,000 feet in the air, man. It's pretty hard.
Okay? Well, try surviving.
Few people have survived falling 20,000 feet
in
the air.
I'm pretty sure I can survive 20 feet in the air listening to Arabic.
20,000 feet.
20,000 feet listening to a man speak Arabic. I'm
so
pretty
you
sure
wouldn't
I'll survive.
Be uncomfortable at all. Not even one little ounce of you.
Hell yeah,
would
be uncomfortable. I probably go to the back. I try to switch spots with a baby.
Go to the back.
But that doesn't matter. The whole thing is
okay.
The whole thing is the fact is like I'll get over it. You know what I'm saying? Like there's nothing wrong with that.
Look, we just need to realize that some things are wrong. You know, stereotyping is wrong.
It is.
But Arabic yelling is synonymous with bombs.
Oh my god.
Just like black people are synonymous with watermelon and chicken. Okay, we all got stereotypes we gotta live by.
How about this? How about you learn how to act on a plane? Okay, I mean that's just it. Doesn't even matter. Even if
it's
you're speaking in English
on planes,
you know not to be shouting on a plane. Like, come on, look, learn how to act on a plane in 2017.
How old is this guy?
He's in his 20s. I don't know.
Okay, see, look, so I'm guessing he was probably in single digits or preteen when 9/11 happened. You really think that really matters to him? It's a joke.
I'm fitting to go on the plane, yeah.
Listen, all right, just learn how to act on the plane in 2017.
Maybe, maybe
I don't
he should watch, Meet the Parents. Boom, 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 boom.
Don't do that. Listen, guys, learn how to act on the plane in 2017. I don't feel bad for you. So, we're going to keep it moving. So, Sound DNA. Pretty soon, you're going to have some new music to have your ear to the streets for. Because there's word on the streets, a little birdie tweet told me that Future and Young Thug are apparently possibly working on a joint project.
Who cares?
Said,
double the mumble, double the jumbo.
Okay. All right, buddy.
But you know, it's probably going to be dope.
Yeah, possibly. I like Young Thug.
You're probably going to need, you know, Rap Genius for about 95% of the album.
Because
both of them are hard to understand sometimes.
I heard Rap Genius gave up on them.
Probably.
That's funny, if that's true.
Man got a sign, like, right on the webpage. Don't come here for Young Thug and Future Lyrics.
Hell yeah, mad question marks.
This happened because Young Thug tweeted out, I think I'm putting Future down with my business. And Future retweeted it, so, you know, had people talking and everything like that. And apparently, you know, Young Thug and 21 Savage are on tour together. So, you know, of course, they've been making music and stuff like that. So someone from 21 Savage's camp was, like, tweeted out Young Thug and Future's project is fire. So that has people talking, like, oh, are they making a... track together? They make a whole project together?
Who gives a damn?
You know, a lot of people are excited. They say it's going to be like the Kanye...
of course it is. Jay-Z, everything is Kanye, Jay-Z,
you know,
watch the talk.
Now I'm playing. I just made that up. But, you know...
I was about to get a lot of this boom.
I was about to do the Kanye. Excuse me. I don't mean to interrupt you, Kayshawn.
I'm going to let you finish,
but... was the greatest album.
Oh, yeah.
But, yeah, apparently... that's what's going to be happening. I'll probably listen to it. I like them, kind of. So, yeah. Anyway.
Good promotion.
Yeah. Listen out to it for it, guys.
Number one fan.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
All right. So, you know, I have two people that I know for sure who's not going to be doing a collab together. Instead, they have beef that's brewing.
Ooh.
Remy Ma.
How do you brew beef?
You put it in the crock pot.
You're making a stew?
They have beef stewing in the crock pot. Oh, yeah. Okay. People listening to this are probably like, I feel uncomfortable right now.
Is this still hip hop?
Yeah.
Okay, so well, like, who's beefing?
Remy Mom and Nicki Minaj, apparently.
Nicki Minaj.
Minaj. What did I say?
Minaj.
Minaj has beef, apparently. Okay, so there is... Remy Ma came out with a line, and it's called Watch Out Remix. It was Watch Out's the remix,
at me
too.
Like I know.
So it's the Watch Out remix. And anyway, so Remy Ma, she spit, you know, 16 bars. She spit a 16 bars, and apparently, you know, people are saying she was dissing Nicki Minaj on this. So if you can.
I'm a Tim's bitch, got my boots on. Got the X-Cons in the Yukon. I don't steal, bitch, I kill, bitch. About to catch me a new charge. Same bitches try to call me. That's how I knew y'all was phony. I be putting in that work, taking in the church, cause I leave them holy. Will I smoke this bitch? Yes. Probably fail my piss test. Get rid of those fake breasts and put a vest on this bitch chest. Lunchtime, she fool. I'm Troy Ave with that tool. Both hands on it like noon. Remy Ma, I'm a goon. City bid, I'm state time. I'm snatching wigs like waistlines. Crack a bitch with my cell phone. Really put her on FaceTime. That ghost right about to call her. That lifeline getting shorter. R.I.P. Biggie Smalls. Why the fuck they ain't want her?
Yo. Oh my god. Ooh, whoa. Is that about Nicki Minaj?
Probably.
That has, this has been waxed off. No, I'm playing. In the words of Apollo.
No, that was not waxed on. That was waxed on.
This
god.
Is waxed on in the words of Apollo.
She said,
all right, Apollo, let me get jokes off.
She but said, this is people talking. Yeah.
She said, take the implants out that bitch chest and put on a bulletproof vest.
Oh my god.
So, you know, Nicki, you gotta say something. They're saying if Nicki responds, this possibly will bring back the culture in hip hop, you know, where Jay-Z and Nas back in the days where they had that whole beef going on. Yeah. So we'll see. Yo, this is exciting, guys.
Why is anytime there's beef, they always say this is going to bring back the culture? It's always the beef that brings back the culture.
Just like when people collab together.
You're not lying.
This is for the culture.
Yeah, mad beefs and the culture still ain't back. I'm confused.
Well, listen, maybe these female MCs can bring it back. So, Nicki, you got to say something because I'm a Barbie fan. But anyways, that's, you know, the grapevine. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Yeah.
Cool, thank you for that, Kayshawn.
Y'all. Wow.
Yeah, my gosh. But yeah, that was amazing. So, what's up next, Sal?
Up next? I'm going to let you know what's up next. I'm putting my ear to the street.
Oh, he's putting his ear to the street. Young Thug the Future?
Hey, Kayshawn, shut the hell up so I can hear what's in the streets.
Future.
I don't know what the hell this is. All right, it's been a happy ass. Close the door.
And we are back with Dose of Dopeness, and we got a guest in here, you know, returning. Only one Tippy.
Yes, ooh. Sir. How y'all doing?
Hey.
All right. We are doing good, man. That don't matter how we doing. How are you doing?
I'm doing good. I'm back on Dose of Dopeness, man. What y'all talking about?
Oh, happy to have you back.
The most amazing drops every time. So I appreciate it.
Yeah, man. Feels good to have you back here, man. So how you been, man?
I've been good, man. Working on some new stuff. Money Religion. What I played for y'all last time.
Yeah.
I have a release date January 1st.
It's already. Okay.
So, yeah.
Well, you heard it, folks.
You ain't not waiting for that drop, man.
Oh, yeah. It's coming. January 1st for sure.
And you ain't got a whole mixtape coming up or album coming up?
So? Nah, just that. I did the single. And right now I'm working with my cousin. We trying to find her single. And I'm working with one of DJ Khaled artists, Steph LaCour.
Yeah.
I don't know if you heard her. She had a song called Saturday. So we trying to find her next single. So.
Yo, good shit. Working out here for real.
Yeah, writing. I told you. That's what I be on. I'm more so focusing on writing in 2017.
I may do
a project. I don't know.
But just writing.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, who needs a project when you getting that money?
Hey.
You know what I'm saying?
Right for somebody who writes music and obviously performs your own music. When you're freestyling, is it hard not to grab from like stuff that you've done in the past?
Hell no.
It's not?
No. I'm gonna be honest with a lot of artists grab verses, recycle verses and all that, but it's not at all. Like it's about the creativity, it's about the art. You wanna make sure like if you're not a freestyler, let's be serious about it. Grab an old verse. That way you won't be stumbling, looking crazy. But if you are a freestyler, go in, do your thing.
Can Sean hear that?
Okay, so it sounds like you. So it sounds like you're a freestyler.
I can. I'm gonna be honest with you. For me to get in my zone, like I gotta be in my zone to like, you know.
Do you like look around the room and grab things to just talk about or whatever? Like when you.
One of those freestyle. People that need to call out words and then you just go off the words.
If y'all give me a slow beat, okay. Don't give me no fast beat thinking Nah, it ain't gonna happen.
Oh man, okay, that's some real stuff.
Right.
But I believe in the art of writing. Like a lot of people, try to mimic what Jay-Z and Biggie do, which is not right, which yeah. I've done that before, but my heart is in actually like writing, being yeah. able to look at
oh,
it.
Oh, shit. Okay. I just, you just helped me realize that Jay is the reason why Atlanta rappers the way they are today.
I wouldn't say that. I think it's the lean. People get lazy.
I don't know, man, because Jay-Z started. He said, I don't write nothing.
Everything but look, though, there's a difference. When you pick apart a Jay-Z song, it sounds like he wrote it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It doesn't sound like he was in the studio freestyling or not writing. So if you're not that talented, or then smart, you need to go back to the pen and paper.
Please, there's nothing wrong with that.
I appreciate that.
Yeah, like I'm of the belief that Jay-Z just has a really big memory. Like he doesn't have to write it because he can think of things and then puts it together in, you know, his head.
Mm-hmm.
You know, not everybody has that brain capacity. I know I don't.
But even when you're in the studio, a lot of people don't understand it's about like, you know, you cut. Yeah. He may go in and do a faux bar. They may attach another 8 to that.
So it's a big process to that.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. It's all about chopping and cutting and placement, just putting the song together.
Word.
But
you ever
usually
made songs like that?
Yeah.
When I'm doing with other people, yeah.
Is it annoying? Because I personally have been in that kind of scenario, and somebody's telling me, yo, you gotta hurry up and bring your bars. So that like,
well, when you was in the studio?
Yeah.
Nah, every time I go to the studio, my songs be done.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm.
My song's already written. Like, I really don't have to look at the paper, but I write it down and I memorize it. That way, it come off more natural. But, yeah, I don't write in the studio. No. Unless if I'm, you know, have a 12-hour block and I can. But normally, I'm in the studio 1-2 hours, so I just...
You knock it out.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you hear that, kids, you do your 5 times each. You write your verses 5 times.
Yeah,
memorize
write it down. Memorize it.
Mm-hmm. We would all appreciate that. Now, everybody, I assume, like, you have writer's block, right? Every once in a while?
I wouldn't say writer's block. It's just I go through spurts where, because normally, like, if I'm writing about a real life event, me personally, I have to get through it in order to write about it. It's not good for me to write about something while I'm in it, like a heartbreak or whatever, because it's not going to come out good, whoever on the other end of that story.
Yeah.
So I'd rather wait, clear my head, then write about it. That's what
I like that.
Yeah. That's actually smart. Yeah.
That's some mature stuff right there.
That's way better. I was going to ask, like, you just go in the woods and start running around anything, so you get some inspiration.
Any music you hear from me is about a previous part of my life. Mm-hmm. So if I'm talking about something, it's something that happened before.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm with that, man. Well, we appreciate you coming in, bro.
I appreciate y'all having me. Dose of Dopeness, man. I love this show.
Yeah, man. Real. Can't wait to hear what he brings to the cypher.
The cypher. Be right, man. It's gonna you be know he's going to be spitting. Oh, don't try to play me out. I'm going to build it up.
Gonna be right. Y'all going to spit with me, though, right?
Yeah.
Maybe.
Everybody.
Yeah.
Everybody
in the room.
Everybody.
Everybody in the room.
Everybody.
Those two. Yeah, those
everybody.
Two.
Everybody.
I know y'all hear us in there. Hey, wait.
Everybody.
He's too arrogant. He's spitting too.
Blacksmith, you coming
too? She said,
Yeah, that's what we need, man.
Case on YouTube.
Come on.
Nah.
You can do our ad list, Blacksmith.
I'll be the background dancer.
Well, I got freestyle too. I know he is.
Yeah, he's been writing some bars. He's been prepared. Look at him.
Really?
Yeah. We see him. Well, y'all, we want to thank you again for coming in. And we got to thank you because we have a song we want to play for you. You already know?
Really?
Yeah, actually, your song.
Really?
Yeah, you want to play for us, you know? If you want to introduce it, Money, and go ahead.
Well, you know, we're going to bring up Only One Tippy, Money, Religion, Produced, and co-signed by Federo. We in here.
Hey. We in here.
Hey.
We back at it again. All right, and we back with Dose of Dopeness, and we have a conversation topic about to discuss. Was 2016 really a bad year?
Maybe.
You know, what happened in 2016? Okay. So until we get to the end, you know, we have some things like, you know, like, I know Prince died, you know.
Yeah.
David Bowie
died. Mm-hmm. You know, Carrie Fisher just died yesterday.
Trump was elected.
Yeah, you know, okay, Trump was elected. You know, Kanye had a breakdown.
Yeah.
We lost our American Idol, Orlando Brown.
Orlando Brown showed the world how crazy he was.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, did you already say man. Princess Leia? Carrie Fisher? Yeah.
Carrie Fisher?
Don't speak her name if you're going
to. I was her biggest fan, man. I'm so sorry.
I bet
you were. Yeah, I already said that. I already said Prince died. What else bad happened in 2016?
I mean, if that's it.
Did Uncle Phil die again?
No. Okay. No. I don't think. Unless he was a zombie. You know something that we don't know?
2016.
Yeah. Well, look, as far as I know, that's all that happened. Was there any good?
There's one more bad, actually.
What?
I found out that I didn't have a cheagle.
Okay.
What does that
doesn't matter. Okay. All right. I mean, I guess it matters for personal, but we're talking about on the grand scheme of things.
See where this conversation's going.
Yeah, but like, was there any good?
Nope. Oh, yeah. We got a confirmation that Young Justice is coming out again.
Season 3.
Okay, season 3.
Yeah. That.
Let's see. What's
that? That outweighs almost, you know, what's 3 deaths. Yeah. In my opinion.
No, I don't know about all that. You know, life. It's pretty important, bro. But I don't know.
Stan Lee's still alive. He turned 94 today.
Oh, that's cool.
I've seen this amazing meme of who had the most L's in 2016.
Tell me that. Yeah, who had the most L's?
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay, yeah. The Meek Mill Drake thing continued.
Yeah.
It did?
You know, Summer 16 was this year. It was Summer 16.
It didn't continue.
Still Drake put out
one more
day.
Verse and Meek Mill said, "I lost." He finally accepted defeat.
Nuh-uh.
And then he got Beanie Siegel.
Was dope,
and then he got Beanie Siegel punched in the face. That's what happened.
Let's see.
Oh, yeah, Beanie Siegel.
Beyonce was named the most charitable celebrity for Black Lives Matter.
Okay, is that a good thing?
Okay, so wait. Does music outweigh these tragedies? That's a good point. Because Lemonade came out. You know, even though Views was not good, Drake still dropped some heat. You know, we heard from J. Cole finally. Kendrick dropped an album.
Kendrick's not good. I don't know
Kid
what
Cudi,
that was.
If you guys like Kid Cudi, dropped an album. Yeah. Absol, Frank Ocean, who've been absent. You know, so does music outweigh tragedies?
No,
that's true.
No, I mean, because, what are you talking about?
No, because music.
Very true. Tragedies within music.
Like what?
Yeah, like what?
Tragedy. Okay. EJ, come to the mic.
Yeah, come to the mic.
She said a lot of tragedies happen within music, and we need...
drop some jewels on us.
George Michael just died.
Who? Wait, what?
George Michael.
George Michael?
Well, George Michael just died.
Okay, damn.
Where's George Michael?
Okay, like, this might be like our youth... Like our youthful ignorance kicking in, but who is George Michael?
Oh, okay, I thought it was just me. I was like... Is that another president?
Is that a singer?
Come on, explain to us. Drop some jewels on here. You know, she had a cup or two.
Okay.
She's ready to tell us all about this George Michael.
George Michael. Isn't that the comedian?
Nah. He's an English singer.
Oh, okay.
He's an English singer.
English
cool.
singer.
Oh, my God.
Songwriter.
Tommy died.
Okay,
he ain't got no job.
All right, we lost you, Jax, over there. It's been nice. I don't get it. We lost a lot of people.
But Dose of Dopeness came in 2016.
Don't put that on us. He said, "Yeah, we lost Prince, David Bowie,
but Tommy,
but we got Dose of Dopeness." Miss, who get the fuck? Like, I don't know. I just think that
Kimbo Slice died this year too.
He did?
Oh, yeah.
This is a long year.
Yeah, a lot of people died.
We don't have
Willy Wonka died.
Really?
Oh my God.
All these people are dying this year, bro. Okay, what about other than Jesus people is taking, dying? Is there anything else other than death?
Muhammad Ali died. Muhammad Ali died this year.
All right.
Oh wow.
Change the topic.
Yeah.
Is the world ending in 2017?
Yes.
I think Jesus is taking all his favorites, so they don't got to deal with the fire.
Nah.
I don't have to deal with the fire, guys.
You know, but these guys wasn't like 30 years old, 40 years old. I mean, you know, so some of them were sick. Prince was sick. Muhammad Ali was sick.
Prince was never sick.
He wasn't sick.
My guy.
He had pain because he kept jumping from amplifiers on his knees. Like he was unbreakable.
That's what the government wants you to believe.
Right.
That's not true. None of that is true. Prince was a healthy individual. And
he was. Everybody was shocked.
Look, man. This is the reason why he was floating in rooms, because he couldn't walk.
Oh, yeah.
It caught up to him.
It makes
sense.
Is there anything other than death, though?
I mean,
yeah, Trump is president.
Death marks the, to me, like, if it was a bad year, how many people died?
I don't want to count. And it's like, like the significance of the people who died. This is a very more. This is a very sad segment.
I mean, I'm still
great death. This what person happened? Died. That person look, died. Oh yeah. This person
2016
died.
2016 was probably a bad year. A lot of stuff happened. Yes, Donald Trump is our president. But if Hillary was our president, would we still be saying it was a bad year?
Yeah. Mm. Why would that be the difference? Yeah,
I mean, because
I don't know. Because I think that people just said like the year just like messed up.
That was
now.
Like the icing on the cake, yeah, right yeah, there. Yeah, you know, like really.
I feel like racism was at an all time high this year.
Seriously, I agree with that right there.
I, think, I mean, I don't think it was at an all time high.
I mean, you know, you got slavery, but come on, now.
In all time, pretty sure there's been worse times for racism.
I'd rather much take slavery than slander on Instagram.
Oh wait, you remember Harriet Tubman? Was going to replace Andrew Jackson on the $20 bill.
Oh, yeah.
Right? I know, but that didn't happen in 2016.
Yeah, oh. That's not been happening yet.
Yeah, you know, like...
Oh, well.
We got a lot of promises this year.
They still got time to change that.
We got mad promises this year.
I'll try.
Well, okay. Hey, like, look. Fine. In all... in the grand scheme of things, the year might be ruined. But what about me?
Okay.
What about what?
Shorty Lowe also died.
That's the guy.
Oh, my God. He did die, too.
You know, he had flavor. And like they put him into a sarcophagus, and they rolled him out into a strip club. His favorite strip club. That's how 16. I want to go out.
In a strip club. That's how you want to go.
Hey Sean, you gonna set that up?
Yes. So you telling me you want to get drove around in a strip club?
Yep.
That's you don't even like.
That's what,
if
like
that's what
my
he wants,
then
that's
do.
What he gets. I guess.
Thank you.
Oh,
I'll play the 2 Chainz song. For your birthday, got a big booty.
No. You had to bury them in the coffin in order for that to work. But anyway, okay. So like, yeah. The year is basically messed up. What about musically? Was this a good year?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah,
no?
I thought so.
No. Because what? They got Drake dropped that good album.
Not
in the
even
beginning.
Just talking hip hop. I mean, R&B hip hop.
The
too,
views.
You know, so
wait,
like, so what? Rihanna dropping. Beyonce dropping,
yes.
You know,
Drake.
Mm-hmm. I mean, yeah, but I was saying outside of hip hop too.
Oh, Rihanna.
So like you had Travis Scott, you had Chance the Rapper, you had Kanye West, you had Beyonce, you had Rihanna. You had Drake,
Kalani.
Yeah,
you listen to Kalani? Oh, Kalani tried to commit suicide. This year's been trash.
Look, man.
Absolutely.
I was
terrible.
Trying to bring some light.
I was trying to shed light, bro.
I'm sorry. Look, man, you keep putting up stuff that just brings it right back to it.
Party Next Door dropped an album. That also reminded me, you know.
Was it even good?
I mean, yeah, like with that I'm with you. Wait, no. That wasn't that song. But you know, that song doesn't make sense now.
Oh, come and see me again.
Come and see me.
Oh, yeah.
Again.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. I don't know, man.
Not to mention, J. Cole came in the fourth quarter. Kid Cudi came in the fourth quarter. Absol came in the fourth quarter. Schoolboy Q came in the middle. But, you know, that's also a dope album. Kendrick came in at the beginning. Kendrick came in the beginning.
He did. Now, stop saying Kendrick. That wasn't the album. That was.
It is still music, bruh.
Look, man, it doesn't count. Kendrick put out 2 songs. Say that.
They were fire.
What are you talking about?
2 songs were fire.
Look, I think that this year... But yeah. I think this year was good, musically wise. I'm like music wise, you know.
He put out a whole album.
Yeah,
no man, he put 2 songs out.
He put out a whole
Blacksmith.
Album.
You need to get it together.
Why does anybody keep saying he put out a whole album?
Anytime you want to hear Blacksmith, you say something bad about Kendrick, and he'll come.
Every time. Every time.
Oh God. Jeez, man.
Yeah, I think musically it's been a really good year, but you know that. Okay. What about you guys?
I mean, personally?
No, musically. Personally and musically.
All right, so let me start personally. Oh, yeah, you know. Oh, you know, musically also. I heard this real fire EP, right? Float.
Oh!
Yeah. So that came out in 2016. Just saying, guys.
Yeah.
You know, I thought Check it was it the out. Best. Maybe it's better than Drake, okay. Rihanna, absolutely. Beyonce, right. All
okay,
of them.
Okay, so yeah, that was dope. That was also... So Sound DNA.
Oh yeah. This year music was okay. It was fine. I live with it. Next year better be better. It's better be better.
I mean better. Like you're probably not gonna hear from J. Cole. You know, I'm probably not gonna hear from Travis Scott. You're probably not gonna hear from Kanye. You're probably not gonna hear from Drake. I mean like album wise. You're probably not gonna hear from Beyonce. Probably not gonna hear from Rihanna.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna say like how are you expecting to be better? You're probably not gonna hear from these guys that dropped an album this year.
Yeah.
Oh, 2016 yeah, trash.
Well, listen, 2017 will be better. Yeah, you know?
I hope so.
Well, hey, you know, at least we got sound DNA's ear to the streets.
Y'all have any resolutions, though?
We have sound DNA's ear to the streets.
We're going to go to the gym for
2017. I'm gonna try to say
we got sound DNA's ear to the streets.
And up next, we got Childish Gambino sweatpants.
Hey, sweatpants, Jim, 2017.
Yeah, yeah.
Jim 2017. Wow, wait. All she
want to do is bang. And we're back with Dose of Dopeness, which the CEO, chairman himself, hasn't been back here since week one.
What?
He is back.
Since then,
with vengeance.
Sell.
Yeah.
It's a new introduction. I got to reintroduce myself because I came as Kingpin. Oh, right. Down back itself.
With okay. 2 L's.
I knew we was exposing that confidential information. Nah, but, you know,
do it to the camera, sir. Hey, Aaron Rodgers. Oh, man. What you been up to other than the name change, bro?
Man, just trying to, you know, get back to the grassroots, get back to the core very thing. The reason why I started doing this in the beginning. Bettering myself as a businessman, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. I see that SoundCloud just keep piling up, man. I can barely listen to all that music.
I can barely keep coming up with this shit.
I can't even go. And I can't keep going on my Instagram anymore because it's nothing but I'm going to eat regardless.
Right?
Shameless plug. Yeah, man. I see you working out there, bro.
Hey, man. I got to live up to the Instagram name.
All right. So what's 2017 hold for?
2017 holds more for Young and Hungry than it does for Sell. You know, I would want to say that we got 3 dope, real dope projects coming out in February, one in June, and one in September. So those are going to be some powerful years for us, you know, one for the history books. And myself, I will be dropping in June, Return of the Wave Chasers. Hey. Y'all make sure y'all get that.
Shit, I just noticed.
I just want to get this one chance. I barely get a chance to correct my brother. He said it's going to be powerful years. It's only 1 year.
All right, shut your ass up, sir. I just noticed something. You're Diddy. You better have 4 names, bro.
Take that.
Yeah, man, because if you come in Kingpin with the bars, and you come in that cell with the business.
Okay.
Hey.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right?
Hey. I can see that. I'm going to take that one. Yeah. I'll take that to the bank.
I'll send you my information for my check later.
Okay.
Wait, yeah. Word. But, yeah. What's going on with Young and Hungry? So you got some projects coming out.
Yes, sir. All right.
When are we getting paid?
Oh, man.
We talk about this later.
You get paid. You can talk to the cameraman. I dropped him something today.
My guy.
All y'all shit.
Yeah.
Before the end of this year.
Cool. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
My guy.
This is just foresight. I'm guessing this is Sound DNA's last show.
I feel like it is.
Oh, man.
I should have went on vacation.
He took a shot when he had it, though, man.
I had to, man. You know?
Okay.
I'm going to lose 2 jobs.
Okay, I want to piggyback off of mine in his last question. Can you tell us any of the projects that you have coming out? Or is this like, you know, hush, hush?
I mean, I can tell you right now because it's a beautiful thing when family's all in the room. You know, we got Apollo dropping in February. Coming up with his project. You got Kayshawn dropping in September. And you got myself dropping in June.
Woo.
So, you know, we're going to have a pretty...
Fire.
That sounds like a saucy year, man.
Right?
That sounds like a triple threat right there.
Triple threat. Not to mention, we got 2 movies that we working on.
Oh,
shout out to EJ. She likes to stay behind the scenes, but shout out to EJ over there.
Can you tell us a little bit about it?
A little bit about him? I don't know. Can we talk about the movie right now? We talking about it.
He does what he feels.
So 2 movies. One of them is a short. It's about drugs and addiction and how people, you know, deal with that, overcoming all the trials and tribulations with that. It's a real short. We're going to be dropping that a little later than we will be doing Bloody Waters.
Ooh.
Or
Bloody Waters.
From Ghetto Streets to Executive Suites.
That sounds intense.
We got those 2 powerhouse movies. All Ghetto Tales is like Paid in Full meets The Social Network.
Yeah.
So we doing one that first, and then we're going to attack the short. All in the meantime, dropping these projects over here. All in the meantime, opening up a studio, getting stronger in these showcases.
Taking over.
So do your legs get tired sleeping, standing up?
Hey, man. I don't even know how to answer that.
Me neither. I'm over here first though, man, because I see you constantly out here working, bro. I just don't get it, man. What motivates you to keep going like this?
I mean,
Because he doesn't know how to stop, I guess.
I'm
going to just say can't stop, won't stop. Man.
Hey.
Can't stop, won't stop.
I thought I told you that we won't stop.
I'm going to eat regardless.
Yo, we appreciate you for coming in, man.
I'm happy to be here. I'm happy to see the growth with all you guys. You know, y'all doing y'all thing up here. Got to show love. And you will be compensated.
Getting paid.
Spoilers. See what happens. Take risks, y'all, because he may get rewarded or fired. You know, depending on who
you
boss.
We'll see on the next show if he's on it.
Yeah, well, I'll let y'all know. Y'all see me on Instagram. But thank you again for coming. But we got a song from you, I believe.
Oh yeah, you got a song for me. Before y'all drop that, y'all make sure y'all follow me. I'ma eat regardless. That's on Twitter. That's on Snap. That's on Instagram. You already know. You don't even follow
it's
me on
Facebook.
It's
on everything.
But, Cell be taking over. Young and Hungry be doing our thing. And go ahead, drop that Resurrection, man.
Resurrection, my favorite.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9
It's the 10K commandments.
Oh man, sadly no, this is not 10K for tonight. It is the DNA commandments. Yeah, I do want to give a little homage, Armin to my boy 10K.
Yeah.
You know, my dude, get better. But I want to do it on the New Year's. Your New Year's going in and coming out.
Okay.
2016, 2017.
What you got?
What I got. Number one.
Okay.
Set your standards low. Okay.
Set your standards low. I wasn't expecting that. Just saying.
All right. Look, if you know what you mean. All right. Look, if you are fat and you have heart disease and you are sickly,
you mind if I be a translator?
Yeah.
Create goals that are reachable. Make short-term goals.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Yeah, that's
pretty
good.
I was expecting that fully.
But I got to get these jokes off to the fat people. You are big and you have heartaches and you can't move, what are you saying you're going to lose 20 pounds for?
Because they can lose 20 pounds.
Why are you
saying? Make it 50 pounds.
First of all, if somebody can lose 20 pounds in a year, I don't care how big they are. If you're big to that point, like I saw some like what my fat
300 pounds year, more.
You're like 600 pound life or whatever. This lady lost 17 pounds in a month. So because she had to, or she couldn't get the gastric bypass surgery. So you can lose that if you want to.
You can do it.
What's the point of cheating? You have to work for it. Anyway, number two, cut off dead weight and bad habits.
But I want my bad habits. I love eating chocolate every night.
You like smoking crack?
Well, sound DNA. You've been holding me down for far too long. Interrupting me. 2017 is going to be a brand new year for Apollo.
The truth comes out.
keep telling yourself that, Apollo. Anyway, cut off your bad habits. If you doing drugs, you smoking that weed, you on that lean, you on all that shit, cut it. Start off a new year. Start off new year, new you. All right, we're going to bring that back one more time. Because I don't want to say that shit ever again.
New year, new you. Like, really.
I'm going to the gym.
That's the epitome of not changing. Saying that phrase. You're never going to change if you say that phrase.
What, new year, new me?
Yeah.
You're never going to change if you keep talking like that. Number three, end positive. Start positive and end positive. What I mean by that is end your year talking positively.
Okay.
Start your year. It'll help you start the year positive and help you push forward being positive to the end of your next year.
I'm going to the gym.
Hmm?
We're just speaking negative about fat people.
Unless you're fat,
right?
And then that does
not horrible.
Matter to you. Okay?
Listen. We got fat listeners, bro. What are you talking about?
Thick listeners.
We probably do. It's too late. I said what I said already. Number four. Forgive 2016. I know it took David Bowie.
I know it didn't take Donald Trump.
Yeah, that too. And I know it didn't take Donald Trump. And also it took Princess Leia to all my Star Wars fans. But let that
I
heart
can't
go.
Forgive.
But Stan Lee's still alive and kicking. 94 years today.
Who?
Stan Lee.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, beautiful.
Let that hurt go. Going to
I
the
can't
year.
Let the hurt go.
You gotta let the hurt go. Because you gotta go into this year fresh.
Yeah.
You ain't gotta forget. You gotta do that.
You ain't gotta forget. Just forgive.
I don't know about that. Oh no, you're right. Yeah, you're right. Yeah. Don't forget. Don't forget. No, he was right. Maybe you should be doing this. Number six. Do not get too much. Hold on. Do not get too much under the influence. Okay?
Like you're
under the
Don't
get like.
Look, I'm already fucking up my whole thing. Do not get too much under influence of 2016.
I don't get it.
So you can go into 2017, clear mind, clear body, clear soul.
Okay. Don't get drunk.
Okay, so wait, I think I know what he's saying. He said, don't get distracted by what happened 2016 once 2017 hits. You know, like clean. Like
is that what
clean.
You meant, Sound DNA?
That's not what
New
I meant
year, new you.
Do you mean drunk? Don't get drunk.
Yeah, pretty much. What are you talking about? That's what I just said.
He's upset.
He said it way better.
He said it in the way. Whatever.
Thank you, sir. Ava, you want to do this? I was wrong with him. All right, number 7. Going totally against what I just said because those people know who y'all were. Hypocrite. This is for the real nigga. Get fucked up. Okay? Going there, going to 2016 at the last year, and I want you to drink. I want you to smoke.
Hey, I
want you to go
started.
In there. You start a little too early. I want you to go in there, and I want you to get messed up. So when you go into 2017, you feeling good.
Oh,
and then
yeah.
you get hungover, and you feel like shit afterwards. All right.
Oh, wait. I will let you know, anybody who takes his advice. You're terrible for following somebody who says get fucked up.
I wrote it down. You want to read it?
Oh, you know, he wrote it down, guys. He wrote it down.
I practiced that in the room. All right, he number 7. Prevent regrets in 2017.
Prevent regrets.
What I mean by that is, if you have someone you care about and you feel like talking to, go do it.
Okay.
Don't go into 2017 with that bullshit.
Get some balls about you.
You want to? You got a job thing that you want to go after? Some position? You know, F a job. But hey, you know what? You got it anyway.
What about a girl?
Tell your boss. Girl, what about a girl?
Well, you know, you have a crush on somebody. You know.
Become a lesbian. All right, is that simple? All right, number 8.
So what you gonna do, Sam?
Become a lesbian. Number 8. Don't drop the Funyuns. Number 9.
Don't drop the Funyuns.
Know your role and whom you're texting. Okay.
Know your listen role and who you're texting.
Yes, for New Year's. Listen to this, because this
like,
is
I like his 10K commandments.
Thank you.
Yeah, I appreciate that.
This is the realest thing.
Don't drop the Funyuns. You don't get it.
Don't drop the Funyuns.
Don't drop the Funyuns.
Are we still on this? I've been skipping. This is right. over.
You're
it
on
was
number
so
9 though.
I'm on number 9. Yeah.
I don't get it. Can you explain it?
Don't drop the Funyuns.
I guess I'll Google it.
We'll talk to you after the air.
Golly, yo. I'm trying to finish this. All right, number 9. Know your role and whom you're texting, okay?
Huh?
Bob, don't freaking text me, bro.
Okay.
On New Year's because you're not that important to me. All right? Call. If That's my mom hard. Can call me, my dad can call me, my but close friends can call me.
Bob can't call you.
You cannot call me.
Well, Bob wants to wish you a happy New Year.
He texts me that. All right? Okay. Kayshawn, you text me that. No, I'm joking. All right. Okay. Number 10.
Hey.
Get him, Apollo.
Yes, hey. I ain't gonna blame it on the liquor. You got one chance.
Apollo, you blame it on the liquor. Nobody coming for New Year's unless you're my mom. All right, number 10. Reflect not on what you regret, but what you respect toward knowing you can meet your goals, what you expect. I wrote it down. It sounded way better. What I'm trying to say is, don't worry about what you did in the past, all right? Because what you did in the past is in the past.
Okay.
Don't focus on your
regrets. Saying what I just said like 4 commandments ago.
Oh my God.
Let him get this out, guys. Come on. Speak your mind.
All right, look. Don't worry about what's going on in the past. All right. Move forward. Stay focused. All right. Anything that you can do in the future, you can achieve it. Just stay positive.
Don't worry about the past. New year, new you. Don't be an ass. Focus on the future.
Before 10K commandments is over, in honor of Curtis, who's in the hospital right now, 10K, the original 10K. Is Drop the Funyuns a real thing?
I don't know.
Okay, all right, we're making it a real thing. 2017, Drop the Funyuns is a hashtag.
I don't like that.
I like
hashtag,
that.
Don't drop the Funyuns.
Don't drop the Funyuns.
I still don't get what that means.
Okay, so you're dropping the Funyuns right now. Okay?
Are you dropping the Funyuns? All right, hashtag don't drop the Funyuns, all right? All right, that was the end for the 10K commandments.
I'm not hashtagging that in the 17.
You better. And then, all right. And for the ears to the streets, we got...
You know, young rich niggas.
You dropping the
Migos?
Funyuns,
rich.
Okay.
I don't know what the hell this is.
He's dropping the Funyuns, guys. He dropped the Funyuns.
Bad and bougie.
Bad and bougie. All right, I dropped the Funyuns. Right. Thank y'all.
We got top.
Dose of dope on IV and
in a hot box.
Hey.
Cooking up dope. And we are back with our second alumni.
Hey.
And Bailey.
Aunt Bailey.
Yo, I'm talking to this one right here. Yo, how y'all doing out there?
Yo, man.
Everybody that's tuned in.
How are you doing?
We've been surviving. Oh, he's going live. He's talking to his fans.
How was your holiday?
My holiday was tremendous.
Yeah.
Okay. I spent a lot of time with my family and did a lot of different things. My mama, she even said to herself, she was like, this is one of her best Christmas she ever had in a long time.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
So was the topless self involved? And
what are you talking about?
The topless elf that was on the segue.
Oh man, you're talking about, what is that? The elf reindeer?
Yeah, the elf reindeer.
The topless. Oh, I see what you're saying.
Where did that?
Explain on that, from? Please.
That character, man. I don't know, man. I just kind of just go in my own waves, you know.
Like, yeah.
What Kid Cudi just said, you know, see, he ain't riding in the waves. He got his own wave. You feel me?
So you just you on your own wave.
Yeah, man. I like to make people smile. I like to make people laugh, you know? So I just go with that.
A true showman.
They don't like it, then shit. You know, shit, they don't like it. But,
right? Just do you, right?
Well, hey, it was very entertaining scrolling down my timeline. I was like, yo.
I'm going to have to see that then, because I want to see the topless elf.
But yeah, so like, what's been new since last time we saw you? Anything
what's poppin'?
Notable happen, man?
I'll tell you guys this. We got an album coming out.
Ooh.
Genius Minds dropping an album.
Okay. Tell us more.
The album's called Go. It's coming out next month.
Go.
Look out for that, everybody out there listening.
Okay.
Shouts outs to the producers, Deuce Beats. Shouts outs to, who else is on there? El Spiffo. Else is on there. I made the beats on there as well.
Okay. You made all of the beats?
Man said double whammy.
The majority of the songs that I made songs to, I made the beats to first.
Okay.
And then I would find a beat that's more extravagant to, and then I move from there. So you guys can look out for that coming next month.
Next month. Okay. So what is it like about, you know?
Well, the album is going to have 22 to 23 tracks on there.
Okay.
Okay. I've been working.
Is that
Shoot.
A double album or are you just like?
That right there, that's a year worth.
Wow. Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So you've been working on this for a while.
Yeah, I've been working on it since last year.
Oh, damn.
And actually, some of the songs that's on the actual album is songs that I wrote 3 years ago.
Oh, damn. Yeah, okay. So okay. This is getting deep cut.
Man,
oh,
yeah. Man, it's the Aunt Bailey in the bag. Digging in the bag.
Okay, look, don't say this. Please stop.
I'm not good at titles. This is a working title.
You tried. Okay. It's okay, Apollo. You tried.
Okay.
Look. All right, bro. So you got to let us know.
What's up?
How the females treating you out here?
Okay. Why you always...
Well, why do, is anything new and
Because
poppin'?
I don't get anything, bro. I don't get nothing.
Okay.
All right, go ahead.
He said it, not me.
I don't believe that. You big dog, Mike. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I want to say that... Shouts out to all the beautiful women out there with a mind.
Mm.
Ooh.
Oh.
I'm very appreciative of those women that are in my life. And
okay.
Shouts out to those that's listening and watching.
Yeah.
You guys are truly appreciated.
And y'all appreciative.
Yes.
You hear that? That means he's getting it out here, right?
Hey, not many people can literally sound that like sincere to multiple people at one time.
Yeah.
Like, you know, he's not lying. That's a gift, dog.
You kind of remind me of LL Cool J from Deliver Some Eva before he met Eva.
Is that transpiration?
Your love life.
He licked his lips too, guys. You need to put that out there.
Okay. He's licking them now.
The
right
LL.
Now.
Kayshawn, be careful.
So your love life was successful in 2016.
I haven't dated a woman for 2 years now.
Oh,
so
okay.
I'm single,
guys. Or women.
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 What is that?
Oh, where is this have you going?
That is gay.
He's single
that
ladies.
That's what that was.
All my single ladies. All right.
Well, okay, so what does 2017 hold for Aunt Bailey and Genius Month?
I haven't got a chance to tell anybody this really much out there. But
exclusive.
The guys that's watching, I got a lot of stuff coming.
Okay.
I may make this move. It's really all in my intuition and in my heart, but I'm really thinking about going back to New York.
Oh, wow.
Really?
You know, I'm going to continue my education at art school and still create and write and work my clothing line and meet new artists and producers and et cetera. But that growth, you know, the movement and those within yourself is what helps you move and be able to adapt and change within
That's
the
true.
World.
That's a big you move, stayed, though.
It is.
So what
into that,
that
into that, I want to say this, bro. Honestly, I hope you don't move to go to New York. I'm gonna tell you why. Because Atlanta needs Aunt Bailey.
Aunt
if y'all
Bailey.
Have never seen this man Aunt Bailey perform, this is an energy that you need in your town, right? 100%. Because this man, you can have the deadest party. You can have a funeral. This man will come in there and perform. I promise you, you will leave with a smile on your face.
Right?
Real shit.
He wants to bring that energy to New York, too. Like, share it with the world.
If you do go to New York, man, New York is very lucky to have you, bro. Right? Best believe that, man. But you are...
Appreciate that.
Absolutely loving Atlanta. And if you do go, we'll absolutely miss you, bro.
Do you know when? Like, are you don't know?
It'll be 2017, most definitely.
The year of change.
The year of change.
That's what it seems like it is.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's nice, though.
So what do you think you'll find in New York that you can't obtain in Atlanta?
Hoes.
Okay. What would be different? Hoes. Well, I definitely know the way of living. I know the people that would be there. Yeah. I know the music. I understand my heritage and where I come from. See, I'm also half white and half Puerto Rican. And the last Christmas I just recently passed.
Where's the black?
The black, you know, that's in the family too, of course.
Yeah, I didn't know that.
You know, I just learned how to salsa and like wine and whatnot. And it's like, I want to get more into my real importance of me understanding of my living is understanding where I came from.
Yeah.
And that's not just me as who I am. I mean, like, as people of where we're going and where we're headed to. You understand? Yeah. Like, I want to be able to help as much as not just myself, but help those around that's looking for a better future.
Hey, man. That's real, bro. Open, we want to thank you for coming in today. Always coming in with the inspiration. Like, I don't know what, man.
Seriously.
And, like, we need more of that. We need more people like you. We appreciate you, bro. But appreciate we're going to go ahead and we're going to hype this up. All right? We're going to bring the time. We're going to turn this up. Because we got a track, I believe.
Is this track going to be on Go?
You have a track, I believe.
Is this track going to be on Go?
Ghetto Bitch?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's definitely going on there. Hey. Actually, the movie, shouts out to,
about the holes.
I'm not sure if she's watching, but shouts out to Jamie Cornelia.
Okay.
Jamie Cornelia.
She's the director of the
video. She's dope.
She's very dope. Any artist that's watching right now, if you need like any video shot, anything like that, shouts out to Jamie Cornelia. Yeah.
Okay, okay. Because
she's really good with what she does.
Good right. People.
Look at this man giving. And Christmas already passed.
Right.
This is who I am naturally, to be honest.
Hey.
I like that.
All right. And up next, we got... Aunt Bailey.
Aunt Bailey.
Ghetto bitch.
Ghetto bitch.
Ghetto bitch. That's tune ghetto in right bitch. Now.
Hey.
We are back.
Yeah.
With 95.
95 troopers.
95. What's going on?
Yeah. What's good? What's good?
Good.
Yo. Yo. So, yeah. Well, we had these guys in here last week, but, you know. Anything happened since last week, man? What's new?
Anything new? What's new? What's popping?
Shit, we've been working. Just grinding still, you know. Got shit.
We got shit in the works.
Still
you know,
not talking to some...
What stuff you got in the works?
We're learning. A couple of singles, you know, probably coming out in the near future. You know, just be looking out for that. You know, it's coming
okay.
out.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Yeah, we're working on shit, man. 2017 gonna be lit.
Word. Oh, we got my guys my mic on?
Nah, come
was,
on,
was 2016
man.
A good year for y'all?
Yeah.
Was 2016 a good year for y'all, would y'all say?
So far, yeah. You know, just being blessed. It feels good to be here alive, you know, working towards something better. So, can't complain.
What? Okay.
So, how was 95 Troopers Holiday? How did they celebrate?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, right now I went out of town. I ain't from here, man. So, you know, I went out of town and shit. Went to Alabama, seen the family and shit for Christmas. Hey.
Okay.
Yeah, same here, you know.
Alabama.
Okay.
Shit, they got Talibans out there, bitch, though, man.
What? Where are you from? No. yo, okay, so what's your New Year's resolution? It's like, what are y'all working on? Hope it's not too high.
No cliches, man. No what losing shit. Weight.
Y'all trying to lose 40 pounds?
Nah, be consistent. Nah, that's all we're trying to do. Continue.
Take over the game.
Yeah.
Game
over.
We're not trying to take the foot off the gas, you know. We're just trying to, we're going all out.
Okay. All yeah, right. I'm with that. I'm trying to go all out myself, man.
That's something that you don't hear. Be consistent.
Yeah.
So that's what I like.
That's all it takes, honestly. No. Consistency.
Yeah, that's true.
Key.
I want to say that. That is very important because a lot of people do always start over, but they forget to keep pushing on and keep pushing forward. So I thought that was like really, like, I like that.
That should have been a part of the 10K commandments.
Nah,
no, man.
No. There's no jokes in that. All right.
All right, so, like, where do you guys see your 2017 peaking at?
Hmm. talking about like what do we expect or something?
Yeah.
Or do you have a set date where it's like 2017, this month, I want this done? Our project or whatever.
What's the goal for 2017?
What's the goal?
I know you said be consistent, but what is that going to lead to?
Exactly.
Money.
We're trying to fire ass tapes.
Yeah, pretty much. And we're trying to open as many doors as possible, you know?
Yeah.
We're not leaving nothing on the table. We're trying to do it all. That's it.
Yeah, all right.
Okay.
Yeah, I can feel that.
All right, how's the love life?
Hey, Keyshawn, you want to bring it up? Bring it up, right?
Look, I don't want to.
How the hoes treating y'all?
How the hoes treating y'all?
Hey man, we gonna keep it moving no matter what. That's all there is to it.
Talk about that.
Yeah. All right, Erica's moving kind of close. She brought us
swinging. Wait, listen, no, it's not hoes.
It's not hoes. It's
don't let EJ carry yourself right. Keyshawn, don't let EJ control
you. Well, you gotta carry yourself right. You can't carry yourself like a hoe.
All women are not hoes.
Exactly.
Right. Just the hoes. Come eventually.
The right woman. Yeah. My guy said, we're back at that again.
I was trying to escape it.
How many times I gotta talk about hoes, bro? I'm here to talk about music.
Exactly.
Yeah, man. Yeah, we're going to go ahead. I'm going to put the mic down. And if he's over,
I'm going to walk out. He's
all right, bro. All right, so how do y'all deal with writer's block? How do y'all deal with writer's block?
Man, don't even know what it is.
I'm saying, man, so what the writer's block
is that?
Come back to it.
Yeah, that's the easiest thing to do. Come back to it. Take a break, you know?
Yeah.
Unless you can keep trying to, or you can smoke out a bag, you know?
Oh, we can talk about smoke? Oh, okay. Thank God. All right. I didn't know how y'all was at that. How much do y'all smoke a day? Thank you.
That's the real reason why they call it 95. That's the real reason right there. So what's y'all preferred?
You know that Cali Kush, that Dro. Is that all the same thing?
Sound.
That Trooper Kush. That Trooper Kush.
That up and down.
Trooper Kush. Trooper Kush. Trooper Kush.
I believe it, man.
How can I get that Trooper Kush?
Okay, so like, do you guys
That's where the line is. Okay. Hey, I'm learning. I'm not a cop, I promise.
Trying to get them in trouble and crap.
He ain't lying.
Alright, so man. Like, being that you guys smoke 95 times, like, women gonna get a weed song for you guys. You know that slow, you know that vibe. You know, so
oh, it's coming. It's on the way. It's on the way.
When? The way? Can you let us know when?
I can't give you a day exactly, you know, but, you know, just stay tuned.
It's coming. You know, it's something I can vibe with. You know, like that booby.
Most definitely. We got you.
All right.
Okay, and cool. I'm going to get one more final question. Snoop or Wiz?
Snoop.
Mm.
Damn, that's shocking.
Wiz.
There it is. 95 Troopers are breaking up tonight. All right, thank y'all for coming then. We appreciate y'all.
Before they leave, though, we got them to introduce their track they about to play, you know?
Oh, yeah. A Lot of My Mind, you know, just dropped recently. Go check that out on SoundCloud.
We'll check out
they
lot
have
my
a lot
mind.
On their mind.
Check Video it. Coming yeah. soon. Look out for that.
And what's y'all Instagrams?
IG, 95 Troopers, SoundCloud, 95 Troopers,
95
individual
troopers.
Pages, me, Young Sonko, YUNGSONKO, and then we got Brian Bailey, BRIBNBBIAY.
Look at
you, Snoop fan.
That nigga know where I'm at on Instagram.
Yeah. Thank y'all for coming in. Can we hit that song? Black?
Yeah, man, I need to listen to
you. A lot on their mind.
I got a lot on my mind, too.
Me, too.
I got a lot on my mind. Better watch your back, and that's at all times, because you never know where they're going.
And we're back with Dose of Dopeness, only to say so long. Hope everybody had an excellent holiday. But, you know, hey, it's going to come around next year. 2016 was a terrible year, we have, you know, explained. But, hey, 2017...
could have been better.
Big things.
Yes, big things.
My year is actually pretty good.
We're still going to be here. I know, yeah. My year is good, too. We came here. But, you know, hey, if you're trying to find us, talk to us individually.
Don't talk to me.
IG.
Hit us up in our DMs.
Upstanding underscore slacker for this guy right here, Apollo.
Don't hit him up in his DM.
Don't hit me up in my DM, because Keyshawn will come with the fierce.
Beat that ass.
Yes.
Beat that ass. And you can find me at SoundDNA on Instagram and Twitter, Facebook when I make it.
And, Facebook when you make it.
Yeah. That's where you find me at. So everybody have a safe year.
You can find me.
Everybody have a safe
year. Adrian K. Sean is on all social medias. You guys should check out Float, my EP, on all music stores, and you pretty much can find it everywhere. So.
And if you want to just see what the team is doing as a unit, follow us at Dopeness Radio. Oops, I'm sorry. Blame it on
us.
Alcohol.
And I just want to say, everybody, thank y'all for listening for this year that we have started and hanging in there with us, because I know that we can be intolerable. And I do appreciate y'all. And hopefully we can have a stronger year next year in 2017.
We will.
Stay blessed.
Take this journey as we continue on through the new year. 2017. We'll see you.
We out.
One less hey.
Yay. Na 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 na, hey hey hey, goodbye. Na 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 na, hey hey hey, goodbye. Na 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 na. Thank you for listening.
It's Dose of Dopeness, nigga!
IBNX Radio. Next 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 Radio.